So today I'm going to show you how to use your Sony camera as a webcam using Sony's Imaging Edge webcam app. So with all that out of the way, let's get started. When it comes to webcams, most modern-day computers have respectable webcam quality. However, if you wish to take your production value up a notch, this will be the solution for you. So to make this simple, all you will need is a Sony camera, the Sony Imaging Edge webcam app, which is not to be confused with the desktop app, and a USB-C cable. And bear in mind, most Sony cameras are compatible with this software, which include the Sony EV10, the A7S III, the Alpha 1, and the FX 3. Make sure you have Sony's Imaging Edge webcam app downloaded, and if not, I have provided a link in the description below to that software. Now, once you download it and run the installer, you will then restart your computer. Next, turn on your camera and double-check the menu settings under the Network tab. There are three important settings to confirm. Control with smartphone should be set to off, PC remote function on, and finally make sure PC remote connection method is set to USB. Now, use the USB-C cable to connect the camera to the computer. And if everything is above board, you should see PC on the right-hand side of the camera's display. Your camera will continually charge as you do have it connected to the computer, and you also have the option to internally record your live stream into the camera if you wish. Now that your camera is connected, your camera will automatically appear in video streaming apps. And as a general rule of thumb, Imaging Edge webcam appears in the settings or preferences of virtually all live video streaming apps. So for example, when you open Zoom, it's under preferences. You click video, then camera, and you will see Sony Imaging Edge webcam in parentheses as an option. For OBS, this is a very popular app. However, you will need to download a previous iteration to function, and I am linking that in the description below. For whatever reason, the current version of OBS does not work with this camera and this software. It just doesn't seem to connect. Now, once you have this previous version, which is version 27.2.4 installed, open OBS, click Video Capture Device. Then under Device, you will see Sony Camera with Imaging Edge in parentheses. From there, you stretch the box to your liking, and you can now proceed to stream to social media channels like Facebook and YouTube. So now that we have this professional image ready to broadcast to the world, what about audio, right? Well, there's a few options. Now, you can use your computer's built-in microphone. You can also use a Bluetooth microphone, like AirPods would be a good example of that. Or you can do what I do, which is I use an external mic like the one you see here. And this is how I record audio. I generally recommend this just because usually the audio quality is much better. And regardless of what method you use, I strongly recommend to use the built-in noise suppression option of all these different live video streaming apps, because generally it works very well and your audience will be very grateful. So that covers both audio and video options to really get the most out of your camera and to have a nice professional image to live stream. So now that we've covered both video and audio options, hopefully you have the tools you need to be able to broadcast your stream to the world. And if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. And as always, if you found this video helpful or insightful, give a big thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, comment below, let me know what you think, and I'll see you in the next one.